A lot of the times I'll see instructional designers or e-learning developers use a text entry field somewhere in the course where they enter in their name and then it basically displays their name throughout the course. And that's a great way to personalize your content and to address the user specifically. But you don't even have to actually prompt them to enter in their name. You can actually grab their name from a learning management system if your course is inside of a learning management system. And I'm going to show you how to do that today. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out learningdojo.ninja. You can check out previous blog posts on augmented reality, storyline, XAPI, anything that you actually want to learn about with learning development, you can check that out. I also have templates on storyline and XAPI, so you can download and use those. And I have full courses from A to Z, everything you need to know about Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 video. But today we're going to focus on capturing who the user is through the learning management system. Now I'm going to use a test learning management system called Scorm Cloud. You can sign up for a free account at cloud.scorm.com. And we're going to use their library and upload a Scorm package and then grab the information who the user is as well as their ID right from the learning record store. Now, before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and clean up some of my old courses here. And this is where I will upload that Scorm package. So coming back into Storyline, instead of prompting the user to enter in their name, we can actually do that. I have a variable created called LMS name. We can do that through a JavaScript trigger. Now, this JavaScript trigger obviously is using JavaScript. So if you're not familiar with JavaScript, that's okay. You can just copy and paste or just copy exactly what I'm doing and I'll explain it as we go here. But we do need to have a trigger that happens as soon as the timeline loads. So I'm going to come in and add a trigger and we're going to execute JavaScript. That's the action that's going to happen is we're going to go ahead and execute some JavaScript. Now, what JavaScript are we going to execute? We're going to enter that in here in a second. But this is going to happen as soon as the timeline starts. So I want this as soon as the page loads, it's going to go ahead and read the information and grab who the user is and display it there. So that is great. I'm going to go ahead and just click on the JavaScript window here. Now, there's a couple things that I need to do. And again, if you're not familiar with JavaScript, don't worry. I'm going to explain it to you. You really just have to copy and paste this in. And then you can reuse this for whatever course that you want. And so I'm going to say var, this is a variable, or actually probably should say let's, and just a different way to say var, if this is a variable. And we're going to say player, we're going to talk to the storyline player equal get player. So this is just a shortcut way that we can refer to the storyline player. Now, whenever we want to refer to the storyline player, we can just type in player instead of having to type in this full thing. Just a shortcut way of doing that. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and say let's, and then we're going to grab the user's name. So I'm going to say my name, and that's going to be the user's name, equals, and this is just variables. It's similar to Storyline, how we're creating variables in Storyline, and then we're using assignments later to say change those variables to a different value. We're doing that exactly the same way here, but we're doing it through just code, which is JavaScript code here. And we're going to say my name equals LMS API. And then we're going to go ahead and say dot get. And it has to be capitalized where you're seeing it capitalized here. So the API has to be all caps. And then get student's name. And then open close parentheses. And then end that with a semicolon. We're going to grab the LMS information. We're going to grab who the student is, and we're going to store it inside of this variable called my name. Now, I want to, when I grab this information, it's actually going to have, it's going to take my last name, and then it's going to have a comma, and then it's going to have my first name. Now, I'm not going to present that to the user as last name, comma, first name. I need to manipulate it a little bit and split it out and kind of rearrange it. So I'm going to do that by creating an array. So we're going to say let array equal, and we're going to grab the value of my name. I'm going to copy that and paste it there. And then we're going to use a split, And we're going to split it at the open close parentheses and then open close quotes there. We're going to split it at the comma. So we're going to split the last name and the first name at that comma. Again, if this doesn't make sense to you, that's okay. Just copy this code and you can just copy and paste it and it will work. So we're going to split it right there. And then we're going to go ahead and say, let's new name. We're going to rearrange this and create a completely new variable. And so that's going to say let new name equal array, because that's the what we have here. We're going to take the first inside of regular brackets. We're going to take the second position, which the second position will be my first name. Again, it's going to be Bat Jeff. So we're going to take the second one, because this one is 0, this one is 1. So we're going to take that second one and we're going to place it first here. And then we're going to say we're going to add a space. So in quotes, we're going to have a space there. Oh, let me bring that back here. And then we're going to add a plus, and then we're going to say array in brackets. We're going to do 0 there. So we're kind of changing, you know, Bat Jeff. We're going to change it, and now it's going to be Jeff Bat is really what we're doing here. And that's it. We just had to manipulate it. We had to split it up. We had to put it into a different value, change around the values, and that's really all that we're doing here. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and say player.setVar, so setVar, open close parentheses, and we're going to grab the LMS name. So this is going to be the LMS name that we have inside of Storyline, and it has to be spelled exactly the same, and it's in quotes. This one is in quotes, so keep that in mind, and we're going to set it with a comma and then new name. That is going to be the new value. We're going to go grab the information and then set it there. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and hit save. Now from here, I could just copy this and I could paste it over and over and over, and I could just always grab it without having to know what the heck this is actually doing. So keep that in mind. All right, so I'm going to copy that and then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click OK there. And then looks like I already had some JavaScript there, but let me just double check here and just make sure it's all working or it looks right. And if it's not working, I guess we'll see that once we publish it out here, but let's go ahead and just publish this out. Now we wanna make sure that we publish this out to Scorm, and we're gonna just publish it out to Scorm 2004 and then click okay. Now your learning management system may be different and it may require some different types of, whether it works better with Scorm 1.2 or second edition of 2004. That's something for you to ask your learning management system there. But I'm going to publish this out, and it's going to ask me if I want to zip these files, and I do, because the published package from Storyline needs to be zipped up in a certain way. If it's not zipped up in a certain way, when it gets uploaded to the learning management system, it may not work, or you may have an error. So keep that in mind. All right, it's published out. I'm going to go ahead and click on zip here. We're going to zip this to my desktop, hit save. And then I'm done with Storyline at this point. So as long as my code was correct, I can go ahead and just come over to Scorm Cloud, click on Import Scorm Package, and then go find that package that was just published, that's zip file here, and then click on Upload. Now if I click on Import Course, depending on the size of your course, it may take a little while to upload, but it's going to upload it to Scorm Cloud. And then as long as that JavaScript worked and I don't have any errors or spelling or anything like that, it will pull that information and it will display that inside of my course here. And the reason why it's displaying it is because I already have these percentage signs to display whatever the value of that variable is. So behind the scenes, actually before the course loads, it's gonna go grab the value and then update the variable, and then now it's gonna display whatever that variable is there. All right, so now let's go ahead and click on launch here. And then if you have this pop-up block, that's fine. Go ahead and click on launch course there, and then launch course right there. So look at that right here. Hey, Jeff Bat, I didn't need to have the user enter in anything. I just take that code, and I'm gonna have this code on my blog so you can just copy and paste it. But I just took that code and I pasted it as far as a trigger when the timeline starts, and now I can use that person's name. If I want to just use the person's first name, then I can actually just get rid of this part right here and just use the array, which has the first name, and just use that. So now I'm just saying, hey, Jeff, instead of hey, Jeff Bat. You could also do a similar thing if you wanted to say player, or let's say let student ID and then equals LMS API dot get student ID. Open close parentheses, that is a SCORM call to get the student ID, and then I can grab whatever the ID is that they have inside of the learning records, or sorry, inside of the learning management system. So that's another way if you wanted to grab their ID and display their ID saying, hey, did you know that your ID is this? And then display it right there. Now, it's not going to, I mean, the person developing the course isn't going to know exactly what it is. So it's not breaking any type of data. Only the person that's logged into the learning management system will see that. So that's a quick way to be able to grab who the person is and display it instead of having them enter in their name, because who knows, they may enter in like, you know, Joe Schmo or something like that. If you have any other questions, feel free to email me, or you can always go back to my website and check out my blog post about previous tips and tricks, download templates, and then also check out my courses on Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and I'll see you on the next one.